Please welcome the technical officials on court number one.
So there's confirmation, Alicia Wei into the semi-final. And obviously we don't know yet who she will meet. And the other quarter-final sees Spain against Chinese Taipei Marin against Tai Su Ying. And of course we'll be watching PV Sindhu against Wang Xian in a little while from now. But we've got men's singles action for you first. Tommy Sugiharu up against Eric Peng, and they'll be on court very shortly.
On court number one, the quarterfinals in men's singles. Please welcome from Indonesia, Tommy Sugiharu. And his opponent from the Netherlands, Eric Peng.
So here come the players. Tommy Sugiharu coming out of the dark onto the arena. They have made it quite a spectacular in terms of the way the lighting and the graphics are done out on court. Eric Peng, he comes across like Mr. Cool, doesn't he? The man from the Netherlands. Everything's in his own time, his own stride. And, well,
he's been quite cool in this tournament so far.
Well, he's caused a few upsets already. Is Tommy Sugiharu one too far?
Well, not with the players he's been beating, I think, so. But is this, it's more or less, I think he has the game in there, but it's more or less, well, he could go to the semi-final, you know. Will he get nervous? Will he?
Because he's been around a while, and you know, who knows? This could be the last chance for him to get a medal at a major championship. But then also Sugiharu, there's a lot of pressure on him. You know, he's the only Indonesian man here this week in terms of the men's singles. You know, there was no Simon Santoso, of course, and.
There's a lot going on down there, yeah.
Yeah, and of course, Dad did what he did here in Copenhagen. Anyway, it's interesting, but I mean, he's the favourite, like the colour of his shirt, the red hot favourite.
Definitely. But it's not like it's not a walkover for Tommy. This the thing that can be Eric's problem is maybe that Tommy's too fast for him, and we've seen Tommy play really, really well in this tournament so far, so.
We saw the match on Monday against Derek Wong. I think he was a little surprised when he took on Vladimir Malkov, came through in the end, but given a little bit of a shock early on. And then yesterday, just 34 minutes, saw off Hu Yun, 21-10, 21-11. So that was a very impressive display. But as you can see, not seeded, ranked 37 in the world. He's never been in the world's top 20, actually, Eric Peng. But he caused an upset yesterday, beat Tanung Sok Sayansom Boonsak of Thailand, 21-16 in the final set. He also beat the number 11 seed, Tian Hao Wei, in straight games. So he's had a really good time. Frank Alstrand from Denmark and Jitin Bata, service judge there, in charge of proceedings here. Here we go. They have met twice before, actually. Tommy Sugiharu has won both of them, but a couple of years since they've met. Those wins coming in 2010, 2011. Yeah, so nerves are going to be jangling, that's for sure, at the start. Both sides, quarterfinals, men's singles.
Ladies and gentlemen, on the right, Tommy Sugiharu, Indonesia. On my left, Eric Peng, Netherlands. Eric Peng to serve, low ball, play.
Well, there's a statement of intent from a go from Tommy Sugiharu. I mean, I noticed from Eric Peng, I was watching him when I was in the arena here in his match against Tian Hao Wei. And he has this kind of languid style. There's nothing hard about the way he hits the shuttle. He even has a tendency to look around the courts elsewhere, see who else is playing after points, you know.
He's got his own style, and so if you can have that style, it's pretty good, because you can fool maybe opponent thinking, well, you don't actually care about this, but he does. It's just always been Eric like that. And he will come up with some shots sometimes where you're thinking, okay, if I did that, I would almost maybe throw my racket out of this arena, but he just keeps going. But as I said, this Tommy here, it's going to be very difficult, because the things that Eric wants to do, Tommy's very good at, and he's just going to keep coming back at you and again and again and again. And he's fast. Tommy's, I think we've seen that he's very, very fast. He's playing a high, high tempo.
His wife's been coaching him part of this year as well, Yaji. Of course, herself was a very good player. It's Runa Massing, though, from the Netherlands Federation, is in the corner.
Played by Tommy. And I think one of the issues is Eric's going to find difficult here is Eric's net is really, really good. He always takes the shot so high at the net, but as we see here, and even though how he can, even no matter how close he's been, so Tommy can just get it to the back court. So he will be working very, very hard, Eric. Look at that defense of Tommy. And then himself. Oh, well read by Eric.
That's what he does so well.
Yeah, he knew that was coming. Look at that look from this one here. There, he's already moving over there. He knows that's coming. And that can confuse. That's a good move. That can confuse Tommy.
Interesting start, isn't it, really?
That's where I see Eric very quick at the net. Standing, because of his height also, he's standing really far up in the court.
all. Stay on court. Service over. 7-7.
Yeah, hang in front. And Tommy's looking, I don't know, what's the word? A little bit inhibited.
Yeah.
Compared to how we saw him the other
day. He's also playing the right tactic.
Service over.
Oh, Chris.
Eight.
No, taking the pace a little bit out, Eric, of the game, and that's confusing Tommy a little bit.
So at the interval, Tommy Cigar is just giving himself a little bit of a gap. But Eric Pang's proving to be a tricky customer, isn't he? 11-8, the scoreline.
Court 1, 20 seconds. Court 1, 20 seconds. Relax, please.
Well, Sugiyato, he said he's been watching video reruns of his father, Ichuk, beating compatriot Liam Sui King for the world title in Copenhagen a number of times, sat down together. Dad told him he should use Copenhagen as the launch pad for his career. Well, you have to say it's a wonderful opportunity given the way the draws set out to reach the semi-finals.
Well, I'm not going to say that Tommy's going to win this tournament. Definitely not the.
Or possibly Chen Long in the Zep, you know.
Chen Long or Li Chengwei, but should he win this one? Isn't it a great story? A dad winning the gold and then this many years later the son comes and wins a bronze. I think that's pretty cool. In the same country. So maybe they should have a statue in Copenhagen somewhere. The Sugiatos.
I think that's reserved for the loud drips, isn't it?
They have one. No, I don't think they should have one. And we put a Schmeichel up there as well. If he hadn't played for Man United.
Okay.
Nah, of course he's. It was the big reason why we won that European Championship in '92. So.
And how highly are. Obviously, you're in the world of badminton, but in the general public, the likes of Morten and the great 13. Danish badminton players.
Oh, they're up there. Everybody knows who they are and are following it. The only thing you can say there has been a little bit of a problem is that most of the tournaments are so far away. Where with the football, it's at the same time, and you know when the teams they're following is playing at time that most of the tournaments in Asia will be at, you know, 3, 4, 5 o'clock in the morning. But in general, everybody, you know, badminton is big in Denmark, and they're so used to good results that it's very difficult to follow sometimes.
And most of the players have made good TV careers, some of the big names as well. Obviously, we've got Morten here this week, Morten Frost commentators. Camilla Martin, right.
Camilla Martin is a presenter for TV3 Denmark, and she's doing both football and other sports, and now she's doing it here in badminton, so she's done really, really well. But also, great personalities, these players as well. So, 14. But I can remember, you know, when I was a little boy coming up watching badminton, I remember Morten, you know, every year, the All England, it was great, you know. You know, a huge star, and he was the reason why I, you know, can't remember how many times I played against him, but it was against the wall or something. so, you know, those are the reasons that we have so many good players. And as I said, it goes all the way back to Erland Kops, who won the All England 7 times, and it's just a great, great tradition of badminton in Denmark.
A lovely flick put away, and which is why it's such a pity, isn't it? Jan yesterday, you know, injured. I mean, I know it went to second game, but it sounds like he was injured very early on in his match.
It's I think
because a lot of kids here, aren't there, this week.
We will today probably still feel the hangover from that one. Very, very sad. I saw the interview with Jan yesterday, and he was in tears. Tried to text him this morning, haven't really got an answer back. I heard he was going to a scan today to get 15. That knee scan, and he could be out for 6 weeks, 10. Actually, so that could miss. He could be missing the Denmark Open also. So, sad, sad news. And the one thing is, if you think about Jan, you think about the tradition that Denmark's had with the men's singles going all the way back to Allan Cups and to Flemming Delves, to Frost, to Morten Frost, to Paul Erik Høje Larsen, to
Peter Gade.
Peter Gade, to. And now Jan was about to step into that line, and I thought he had a really, really good chance in this. He's been doing better than ever. He had been prepared the best I've seen. I've seen him in training. He's looked good. He's been calm. You know, some of the demons that sometimes took him away in games. With that win in Indonesia, I thought that was away. And then, but it's sports. You know, you never know what's going to happen. But he'll bounce back. He's a Liverpool fan too.
No wonder you like him so much. No. Well, Eric Pang still offering the odd moments of brilliance like here to reduce the deficit a little bit. Feeling that Tommy Sugiarto here has just got enough of a gap, at least to see this first game off. Yeah, it's always a shame for the host nation here, obviously Denmark, hosting this World Championship for the first time in 15 years, that, you know, the flag bearer in the men's singles that had to go out so cruelly. By the way, that women's singles match I was telling you about earlier on, it's still going on into extra points in the third game, and Punk reduces the deficit now to just a couple of points.
15.
Yeah, and he's actually playing the quite cool game tactically-wise as well. I think he's really knowing what Tommy does. The thing is, can he fulfill that tactic? That's the problem. Oh! Great shot by Eric.
14, 15.
But look how Tommy almost gets that back. He takes the tape. That's a great shot.
There is a one.
16-14. Yeah. Right on the line.
15.
That was me just, what was it, that 3-4 minutes ago, saying, well, maybe this first game is beyond him despite some excellence. And well, he's right in it now. 16-15. By the way, it's Mitani Minatsu who has booked her place in the women's single semi-finals against Li Shuwei. 22-20. She won it in the final game after losing that first set 21-9. That was some turnaround in that one. And that's out. And it's Eric Pang who leads here in this men's singles clash.
17-16.
And he's keeping the attack. He's constantly putting Tommy under pressure. And Tommy just can't seem to get away from it. Really playing at a fast pace as well. And look at these flat lifts that Tommy makes. It makes them very difficult for him. Eric is ready for them.
It was 15-10 that Sugiarto led. But there you are. Yes. Back level again now.
There is over.
But it's these lifts, flat lifts away from the net that punishes Tommy here. He gets out of it. But you can see that Eric is ready for them now, so he needs to get it past Eric to the back line. There, that's a better shot. And there he can commit when he's offensive. Smashes. But if he plays too flat, Eric is so good at jumping into the shuttles, and then he comes forward and attacks, so.
Denmark.
was a great shot.
Kung here. 19. He's very much in the veteran ranks, isn't he? 32 oh. years of age.
Really, and it's so difficult for Tommy to be in defense because Eric is hitting those smashes down straight and hitting the lines perfectly, so he can't really get out of it. And now from Eric can just follow up on it all the time.
Oh, it's just long.
So challenging. But lucky there, Tommy. I want to see that one again. Oh, challenge it.
It was in.
It's in.
It was in. Oh, my goodness, mate. It should be game points. Look at this. That's in.
But this is where Tommy's shoulder was out, you know.
Come on.
Umpire, say something.
Well, what, Eric, you haven't used the challenge. It's 19-0.
Oof.
I've had confirmation from Hawkeye that it definitely was in. Should be game.
Yeah.
Now, that should have been game point.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what the challenges are there for. Use them.
Yeah.
I suppose when you're 32 and they've only just come around, it's hard to get used to it. But it is game point now.
That's wide. Ooh. Eric's controlling the game now.
Oh.
But it's really Tommy who's under pressure. Constantly in a defensive stance. And Eric really forcing him to move low in the legs.
Well, 20 points all. 15-10, Sugiharto led in this game. Eric Punk at 19-80. Not challenging when a challenge would have won him the point. And now it's game point, Sugiharto.
21-20.
Think about that challenge. He should be on the other side now, Eric.
The good news mentally is that he's not aware.
Are you sure? No. No. He's not aware, of course. But man, when he sees this afterwards.
Sugiharto that, somehow has come out on top in this game. It looked as if Eric Pang was riding the momentum there to an opening game win, but Sugiharto's come through, 22-20. But a real talking point when at 19-18, Hawkeye would have given him a winner. So the opening game goes the way of the Indonesian. Is there more life yet for Eric Punk? Thank you.
Court 1, 20 seconds. Court 1, 20 seconds. Hold on, please. Second game.
Well, interesting. Very interesting opening game, wasn't it? Tommy Sugiarto, the favourite, coming out on top, but well, things could have been very different.
Game's over. One.
And it's funny, isn't it, when you know we look at a lot of badminton players and you know 28, 29, they're seen as veterans, and yeah, here's a player who's 32, still looking strong, looking as good as ever.
Yeah.
Why is it that at the age of 28, 29, you're seen as almost beyond? Why can't, like, footballers, badminton players go to their mid-30s?
It's too hard.
Really? I mean, yeah. Physically?
Physically, it's too hard. I won't mention names, but the players I've seen after their career, singles players, well, they can feel they've been playing for that long. And I know with knees and angles and everything, it's just too hard. You have to move too much around the court. Doubles players are a little bit easier because you have two there and you don't have to cover so much. But the coverage on court is too hard. I don't think it's so much the physical, you know, the stamina. Apart from you also, it's going to be harder and harder to keep that. It's just too hard. I would even say that in badminton, after the scoring system changed to 21 with running score, well, it's gotten easier to play the long, you know, in a little bit later in your career. We have to remember the old system, you had to have the serve to win a point. So it just took, you know, you could have players in there, young players who just knew well.
So is that why Lin Dan's done what he's done? So that he could play at the Olympics?
I'm not saying, I'm not saying that, but I'm just saying
I'm saying to avoid the stresses on his body, he's played over the last couple of years. So that
hasn't hurt, you know. That hasn't hurt. You know, we're talking about...
Eventually decided to play that one, Sugiarto, but
just,
too late.
Just watch the Commonwealth players here. They have to train really, really hard up to three events. Some of them three events. Saina didn't do it, but if she had played the Commonwealth, well, and it's just very... It's, and then it's expected of her to do well in all the tournaments. You can't just go out in the tournament here and here and then just move on to the next one. You have these certain tournaments you have to do it in. It's not like some other sports that have more tournaments week after week after week after week. So
you can pick and choose.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, that's the tournament you have to do well in. Do well. If not, that's not good. Train up to the next one. You know, that's not... So it's very hard. And now you don't... We could say with the change to 21, you took a little bit of the stamina away, but that has equaled itself a little bit out now after people have gotten used to it. So, but you could have players. I remember there was players where you could say skill-wise wasn't the, you know, the best players in the world, but they were really hard workers and they didn't care if it took half an hour, 5-0. They just played up and up and up again. They also changed the doubles quite a lot. That's why we see the doubles game being like it is today. Well, people go more for it where, you know, you have players where, well, just play it up and play defense because, you know, we can catch them. It's not easy now when you're already behind 5-0 and it's in this running score, then the pressure is there. Remember when men's doubles used to have first and second server as well.
So at 32, he's kind of the exception to the rule then, Eric, here.
He's not the exception to the rule, but
service over.
So there's not, I can't see anyone else.
No,
punching at that age, really, generally in the
definitely
game.
Definitely not easy.
In men's or women's, really.
No, definitely not easy. And well, the last was probably Peter Gade, who was, what was he, 35 or 34 when he quit?
Yeah.
Oh. Not allowed to dry themselves, being told to stay on court.
It's a 6-4 the lead here for Eric Bunk. I mean, you got to feel Tommy a little fortunate in some respect to come away with that opening game. And
definitely.
He might need it.
Yeah. The thing is that Eric is standing so far up on court and just pushing on Tommy. And Tommy's only kind of in surviving mode. But he can't get it away from Eric. Eric has a great reach and he's got great smashes down the line. So it's a big problem for him. That battle right there, that Eric would win that one.
Five points in a row here for Punk. Here into that flat again. He's disgusted with himself. Here's Punk there.
Great shot by
seven, eight.
Tommy, look at that, how high he gets up. Use the cross mesh. And then you can just see that Eric's very precise with his matches down the line.
Eight.
Well, this men's singles match really, really is a fascinating watch, contrasting styles, and of course a couple of really good stories as well behind both these players. So Chen Long is on the other court. The likely opponent, you would think, for the winner here, although Sean Wanho has taken an early lead in that last eight match that's going on.
Here we go.
Well, he's looking good, you have to say, Eric Pang here. From Groningen in Holland is 11-8 up here at the break. Remember, a game down, 22-20. Sigurdsson saving a game point coming through.
A little bit of a different approach now from Tommy, trying to rally instead of hitting hard and everything. I think that's a wise choice. He just got to be ready for it, and he has to be ready for that. Eric has these stick smashes, comes from a really, really steep, and that's a better approach there. Overdid it there though. It does look like we're heading into to three games.
Then again, it was 15-10 Sigurdsson's way in that opening game.
But I just think ever since then, we have to remember, he should have won that first set.
Yeah.
That he's had momentum.
I know you don't always get what you deserve, but he kind of, nicely done by Tommy, by the way, there.
Oh, yeah.
He kind of deserves a third set here, doesn't he? You don't always get what you deserve, we know that.
No. And sometimes you get what you didn't expect.
By the way, Chen Long 13-8 down.
What?
Yeah, saw the gap there, couldn't quite find it, Punk.
Eleven.
And that's the game. I simply don't understand what Tommy's doing there. Playing it up to a guy who's well known for being using his height properly, and he's playing the flat lift all the time, straight into Eric's game. Really need to refocus his tactical skills. This is definitely not going the right way.
Some working out to do here for Sugiarto.
I don't think anybody's told Eric about the challenge.
Well, he must know.
Well, at that time he looked like what? And then, but then again, well,
yeah,
as we said, he doesn't.
Just hearing it was just out, but as you say, worth a challenge. And
it's a great, great.
He must know.
Yeah, of course he knows, but it's.
13, 17.
He haven't used any of them, and this one I know probably was good, but.
Tight, he needs to really go on a run here, Sugiarto, if he's going to close out the match in this game. That's 4 points in a row, 17-11. Now Pung's hopes of a third game. Still look good, but a little nervier. That helps. Yeah, a little bit short the lift from Sugiarto. Got its punishment. He's looking up to the lights. There was Eric Pang. It has changed a little bit, the lighting here, because of course we've gone from four courts to two. But really shouldn't have been a reason for missing that one. It's 18-0, would you believe it?
Yeah, maybe a little bit of nervousness setting in. But Eric, this is a mistake we haven't seen him do at all, the whole game. Great smash. Unbelievable. 19-18. And on the other court, after being behind 13-8, one of the favorites has, oh, fantastic by Tommy, has turned it around to Chin Long.
What a turnaround this has been. It's unbelievable. I mean, it's match points now.
I think it's, you know, mentally he's probably
17-11 it was.
He does look a little bit tired now.
Nine of the last 10 points have gone the way of Tommy Sugiarto. He's on the verge of a world championship medal here.
Great save.
But one match point save. One at least to go.
He does seem to walk a little bit around some more. Eric, have we seen him before?
Well, Tommy Sugiarto still has the opportunity here in Copenhagen to follow in the footsteps of his father, Ichuk. But there'll be some regrets there for Eric Punk.
Oh, definitely. But it actually looked like he really, really, you know, lost his pace.
Well, Punk applauds the supporters here in the Better Up Super Arena, but goodness me, that could have easily been the reverse result. Yeah, Sugiarto dodged one there.
And Eric is looking for me, he's shaking his head. I think he just ran out of gas. There was nothing left in him. And that can happen. And, you know, Tommy just capitalizing on it. You know, that's what you have to do.
Well, there's the scoreline. 22-20, 21-19. He'll meet either Chen Long or Sean Wanho. So just confirmation, Sugiarto, the first man into the semi-finals of this year's World Championships. Sean Wanho, Chin Long stood on court, and then of course later on today, Lee Chong Wei, Wang Zhengming, Chu Tien Chen up against Denmark's only hope left in the men's singles now, of course, after Jorgensen's injury, Victor Axelsen. And here's the last two matches for the first session here on court one. PV Sindhu next up against Wang Xian, and then the women's doubles, Mersuari and Polly of Indonesia taking on Kakiwa and Maeda. And this is how they got through from the last round, taking on the winner of Tai Su Ying and Carolina Marin. Great win, wasn't it, yesterday for Marin over Wang Yihan. You've got to say, not only a great win, but the manner of the win as well. Big shock. She's some player, isn't she, Marin?
Yeah. Big fighter.
I didn't realise she was still so young as well. She's only, 21?
Yeah.
So, this should be interesting. We've already seen on the other side of the draw that it's Nishue and Minatsu Mitani into the semi-finals. Great comeback today from Mitani in her match against Sung Ji Hyun. And Simon Awell just really couldn't do enough against Nishue, who was very impressive. So we're really getting to the stage now where everything's kind of taking shape, isn't it?
And Chen Long, of course, took that first set. So after a scare in the start.